guys! So, you guys know we're a reaction channel, but today we're gonna be doing something a little different from a reaction video. So, I have recently got in touch with former Chocolat member Melanie, and I contacted her and asked her if it was okay to ask her some questions about Chocolat, what happened, and just like some questions about the K-pop industry that maybe you guys would be interested in. So if you guys didn't know, Chocolat was a South Korean girl group created by Paramount Music in 2011. The group's name stems from the idea that each member is a reminiscent of a different type of chocolate. So the members consist of Jaehyun, Minsoa, Julianne, Tia, and Melanie. So the group debuted in 2011 with the song Syndrome. They ultimately came to a disbandment in 2017. Today we're going to be talking about what happened to Chocolat for those who do remember and kind of dive into a K-pop group, the formation, specifically Chocolat, and just learn more about the group and the K-pop industry, and maybe some of your questions will be answered as well. So I'm going to sit down with Melanie from Chocolat, formerly from Chocolat, and we're gonna talk to her. Thank you so much for taking your time to talk to me.
No problem.
So, I guess we should start off talking about you, right? So, so basically, when did you decide that you wanted to become a singer?
There was ever a point in time where I decided I want to be a K-pop singer.
Yeah.
I just always liked singing and then dancing, and at the time I was really into K-pop. So when the opportunity came, I was just kind of like, why not, you know?
Oh, so K-pop was something that you were into as you were growing up, right?
Yeah.
So what were some of your like favorite artists back then? And if you're still listening to K-pop now, what are some of your favorite artists now?
Back then. God, that was like a while ago.
I know. We're the same age, I believe. So like I'm pretty sure we were like what, 13?
How old are you?
I'm 21, turning 22 this year.
Yeah, we are the same age.
Yeah.
You're right. I think 12 or 13 is yeah. Right. I know. I remember I really liked Big Bang.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Big Bang. Yeah. Oh, 21, too.
Oh, 21, yes. Yeah. Of course. Legendary. The YG.
They're like the only ones that, yeah. Like, stand out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you like any groups now, or?
Right now. I like Mamamoo.
Okay.
And I like Chungha.
Oh yes, Chocolat is really good.
Yeah. Other than that, it's all right.
It's all right, yeah. That's all
It's
right. So if you don't mind explaining, what are you doing now? Like, what are your plans and stuff like that?
plans. I don't know. It's still up in the air. I'm going to school.
Okay.
I'm trying to get through that.
So what are you
But yeah.
studying?
Well, right now I'm studying health services management.
Oh, okay.
So different, right? I went from like
Yeah. It's like
here.
K-pop star to health services and
It's
management.
so different. But yeah, right now that's it. I was working for a little bit, but then I went to Korea for a little bit and came back. Plans, I don't know. I'm just taking it day by day. I don't know.
So time to talk about Chocolat. And I'm like really nervous because I actually love Chocolat so much back in the day. Like I remember when you girls debuted, I was like, oh, wow, these girls are like around my age. That's like crazy. And I'm here like just like going into like what, high school? I'm not doing anything. These girls are so talented. And like,
You know, that's how I feel about Kylie Jenner right now. I
oh
like look
yeah.
at her, and like
Yeah.
I know I'm just like, wow,
Yeah, she's like
maybe
out
she's
here
a
making like, yeah.
billionaire.
And then we're just here like, yeah.
Whatever. Yeah.
So let's start off with the basic questions. How was Chocolat formed and what was the audition process like? How were the members picked? I know you guys started off with 5 members, right?
I'm sorry, my dogs are barking. Can
No,
you
it's
hear
fine.
that? So it was a weird situation if I think about it now. So basically, me and Tia were friends.
Yeah.
Well, we went to middle school together.
Oh,
Our
okay.
moms were prior friends for like a long time,
Oh,
and
okay.
Tia was already into this whole the whole K not K-pop, but like the entertainment industry in
Okay.
Korea, and that's how she met my former CEO. And you know, he was like, hey, I want to start a biracial girl group. Do you know anybody? And where I lived in Korea, it's like biracial central, right? Everybody
Yeah.
is like half of something.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're talking as Tia, and they were looking for people. But you know, since Tia's mom knew my mom, they were like, why don't you ask Melanie? And I was like, sure, why not? K-pop, why not? And I was like, yeah, sure, I'll do it. And then my mom knew Julianne's mom, and that's how Julianne got into it. And the other
Oh.
two Korean girls, my boss somehow found them.
Oh,
I don't
okay.
really know exactly how. I just know that he like was searching and he found them, and that's how it happened.
Oh, interesting. So it's like not really like the traditional way of like auditioning and like recruiting members. Because I know nowadays it's like so competitive and like people are like constantly auditioning and then they're like getting selected. A lot of people are going on survival shows to compete to debut. And it's like, wow, it's crazy. So it was more like you guys were just like a group of like friends and you just kind of got together like, hey, let's do this thing. Wow, interesting. Okay, so Chocolat became known for being like a mixed race, biracial group in the industry back in 2011. So, how was this perceived by the industry and the general public in Korea? Like, what was your personal opinion on the concept and like how did other people react to it when they heard about it? Just like from like an entertainment perspective.
Well, for me, I didn't really see what the big deal was because, you know, I'm biracial, right? So I grew up biracial. So I didn't really see what the big deal was, but apparently it was gonna be magical. So I was like, ooh, whatever. By the general public, I guess when we like first announced our debut, people were kind of like, I guess they were interested. They were like, oh, biracial. I wonder. Like, you know, they're just interested. It piqued the interest in a lot of people. And honestly, I think the actual like people in K-pop really couldn't give like they really didn't care.
Oh, really?
I think they could have cared less, the actual people in the K-pop industry. Other than the fact that some people who like knew English or who were like from America, they would, you know, kind of try to be friends or be friendly because, you know, same culture, I guess.
Yeah.
But other than that, yeah, that's pretty much, yeah.
Wow. Okay, so moving on to the next question. So Chocolat released around 4 singles, I think, in total throughout your 6 years together. So out of all your singles, which one was your favorite? I loved Black Tinkerbell. That was like my shit.
And too. Syndrome, I like that one the best too.
Yeah, like Black Tinkerbell, it was so good. Like, I remember it came out, I was like, this is so different from like Syndrome. What the heck?
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think in my opinion, we all liked Black Tinkerbell the best too. It was kind of like the only song we ever had a say in.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I think that's why we all liked it. Well, I mean, the song itself was just better than Syndrome. Like, it's even Syndrome. Like, oh my god. That will haunt me forever.
Syndrome was like that one song that like at first when you listen to it, you'll be like, what? But then afterwards, it'll be such a bop. Like, I still listen to it to this day.
I've heard Syndrome. Let me tell you, I've heard that song maybe like 10,000 times, right? I have never once thought that it was a bop.
Really? Wow.
No.
What was your first impression when you first heard it?
When I first heard it?
Yeah.
What is this?
I was like, is this really going to be our debut song?
Yes! Girl, yes! Okay? From the minute I heard the song till the moment they chopped all my hair off, what's going on?
So this has been a very hot topic lately. I don't know if you heard about the Inkigayo sandwich. It's like a sandwich that is given out during Inkigayo, like in the cafeteria or something like that. A lot of idols apparently like they like slip their phone number into there if they're interested in somebody like that. Was that a thing back in the day or is this just like a recent thing?
Like secretly dating, trying to get numbers?
Yeah, I think so. Like I didn't really look too much into it. I just know like a lot of people are just like, now they make memes out of it, like the Inkigayo sandwich, blah, 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 this and that. Like it's memes everywhere.
All right, dang, I feel bad. I have no tea. Not that much tea.
Not that much. Girl, just spill everything.
No. Not that kind of things, mm-hmm. like sandwiches or like being super sneaky like that. I don't remember that.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I just wasn't like sought after enough. I don't know. I think one of the easiest ways I have seen people like get together mm-hmm. are DMing each other on Twitter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like they DM each other and then, you know, either get numbers through there and stuff. I've gotten a DM too.
Really?
So surprising. I know, like, look at me, right? At the time, no. Yeah, a lot of people do that. I mean, because it's kind of easy, right? It's discreet. You don't have to follow someone to DM them and nobody would know. Or if you're, like, already friends with, like, other female idols, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then the guy idols who know your friend idol will ask your friend for, like, this person's number and that, you know?
Oh.
Like, there's a lot of tricky ways these people do it, but I've never experience the sandwich before.
Oh, okay, that's interesting. So like I said, you're from a pretty small company, and so like there's only that other actor and then your group, right? So what was the reason that it took so long for you guys to have a comeback? Like, they could have focused all their energy on you to like kind of push your group into like the spotlight more, to get more gigs, to like just kind of promote more, right? Like, I know you guys, through 6 years, you guys only had, like, 4 singles. Like, what goes on?
Okay. Let me think. I know the reason for why Black Tinkerbell took so long. I'm, like, a little hazy on why we waited so long for one more day. I feel like it was because our company was, like, exploring options, right, on what to do with us,
okay,
how we're gonna do things and like what direction we're gonna go. Our company was kind of like, you know, oh my god, what do we do, right?
Yeah.
But also, like, I kind of didn't want to go back. always kind of like, you know, meh. But no, I think for one more day, it was mainly because our company just was confused, right? They didn't know what to do with us. Our CEO was kind of in shock that we weren't doing that well.
Well, it was only like two comebacks. I mean, it takes a while until you actually hit that point, right?
Yeah, but you know, when you keep telling yourself something, like it's gonna work, it's gonna be great, you know, you kind of, you believe that eventually, yeah. And then when like reality happens and it's just not at all what you thought it was gonna be, I think it kind of like broke his head, like it broke him, right? So he was kind of confused on what to do. He was just like, he was confused about our group dynamic. Should he add a member? Should he take out? Like, what would he do? And he was also just, this is just me thinking what I think happened, but like, I'm talking as if we were communicated to, which we weren't. So,
okay.
Wow. Black Tinkerbell for sure. I was just done. I really, really didn't want to go back. I really didn't want to. And I never said I didn't want to do it because that would get me in a lot of trouble, right?
Yeah.
Legally and with, like, you know, socially, I guess.
Uh-huh.
But I really didn't want to go back. So I used any kind of excuse I could say. I was telling my mom, I don't want to go back. Like, don't let me go back. I was just done. But then eventually, you know, there's a contract. I didn't want to pay some $1,000 to, like, break the contract. So I went back, and then we did Black Tinkerbell. And then we did, that was the end.
Wow. So it was just more of, like, you waiting until your contract was over, until you could escape that type of, like binding down legally, right? Wow.
Yeah. Well, because it wasn't even just, like, I only found out about this recently, too, because I'm only now, my parents were, like, talking to me about it.
Yeah.
But, like, if it was just, like, you know, a few thousand dollars, I mean, that's still a lot of money, but to break the contract, if it was, like, a few thousand dollars, my parents were, like, maybe we would have considered that, right? Mm-hmm. But, like, they wanted me to pay, like, in the tens of thousands of dollars to break the contract, and...
Wow.
You know, I understand why my parents didn't let me do that.
Yeah.
It's not that big of a deal now. Things turned out fine.
That's good. That's really good to hear,
time,
though.
I thought the world was ending.
I know in Black Tinkerbell, there was like supposed to be a new member, Lori, right?
Yeah.
I remember hearing about that and like how you guys were going to add a new member and then like you guys were going to have a comeback after that with her and after Black Tinkerbell. And I was like, oh, that's so cool. I'm excited. But then you guys just kind of disappeared off the planet. So like what happened in between like adding Lori and then like what ultimately led to your disbandment?
I think... By that point, right, by Black Tinkerbell, mm-hmm. I was done, but I also think, like, a lot of the other girls felt, like, done, too.
Okay.
Maybe some not with the, maybe not with K-pop, but, like, with the group, right? We were all just, like, this isn't working, right? Like, obviously, I'm not 100%. That means we're not gonna, like, get the results we want, and... I don't know. Everybody just kind of slowly like went their own ways, if that makes sense. Like there was never a point in time when we were like, this is it. Like we're done. Right.
Okay.
It was just kind of like after Black Tinkerbell, I think even our boss knew like this was a flop, like it's done. And so, you know, after that, he kind of tried to have me go on a few shows here and there. He really, really, really had, like, Tia. He was pushing Tia.
Yeah, no, Tia was everywhere. I remember, like, I was like, yeah, okay, we get it. But, yeah, no, she's, like, still, like, very active within, like, the K-pop entertainment industry. Like,
yeah. Yeah, well, that's why I said I don't think some of us, like, she wasn't done with K-pop.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she still loves K-pop and the industry. But, like, just from the beginning, right, it was just all wrong, like the untraditional way of like auditioning, just the whole process, how young we all were,
yeah,
and just the company and everything. It just from the beginning, it was meant to be doomed, right? If I see it from now, that's how I see it.
Okay.
And, you know, I guess through that experience, I realized by Black Tinkerbell that just wasn't what I wanted. It was just too much for me. I couldn't handle it, and I was done. I never said I didn't want to do this to our boss. But I think he kind of knew,
mm-hmm.
obviously, because I was making excuses. It just slowly, we all went our own ways after Black Tinkerbell. Never said, this is it, we're the end. But we all just kind of waited until the contract ran out, right? And then my boss called saying, all right, your contract's up. Like, I'll sign the release form. And I was like, really? Okay.
Finally.
Yay! No, but yeah.
So it was like a lot of, like a burden just being lifted off their shoulders after your contract ended, huh?
Yeah, because I couldn't talk about it. Mm-hmm. I mean, even now I'm only like choosing my words carefully because, you know, I don't want to get sued.
Definitely,
like, I don't know the law or like we all had such different ambitions, right?
Oh, really?
Yeah, we all did, you know, so.
Okay, that's interesting. I guess that's what comes with, like, just, like, not the traditional way, because, like, if they did it the traditional way, everybody would have kind of, like, been eager to debut, been eager to please, and, like, everybody would have had, like, the same ambition. But because, like, you guys were recruited in such a different way, I feel like that was also probably why.
Well, that's a really good point you made, actually. I never thought about that.
Because, like, a lot of people who are, like, auditioning and stuff like that and training and getting to that debut point, they're, like, fighting to be in that debut group, right? So, obviously, like, everybody's eager and passionate and they, like, try really hard. And, like, once they do make that part, it's, like, they have to keep continuing because you have trained and made it so far. So, what's the point in giving up now, right?
Right.
So, it's understandable, though.